mistakes in measuring length of objects. Part 1.
Hello children, in the previous video we learned non-standard units to measure the length of objects using foot. In this video we will see common mistakes while measuring the length of objects that should be avoided. Today Chotu and Pinky's mother has brought a new blackboard for them. They are both making something with chalk on the blackboard and Pinky said to Chotu,
Chotu, you can't make anything here. This is my space.
No, Pinky, you have plenty of space. I will make it here.
Seeing Chotu and Pinky arguing, their mother comes there.
Chotu, Pinky, why don't you do one thing? You take a measure of your space. It will tell you if any of you has more space.
Yes, Mummy. It is right.
But how will we measure, Mummy?
Do one thing. Bring that pencil from the table and measure the blackboard.
Chotu gets the pencil from the table.
Chotu, first keep the pencil at the starting point and see how many pencils are required to measure.
Okay, Mummy.
Chotu begins to measure the space with his pencil.
One pencil. Two pencils. Three pencils.
Hey, Chotu, you are doing it wrong.
Why, Mummy?
While measuring, the entire length has to be measured. No part should be missed. And you are leaving the space while placing the pencil.
Oh, now I get it. I will measure it again. So here it is, one pencil, two pencils, three pencils, four pencils. This means I have a total of four pencil long space. Pinky, now it is your turn.
I have one pencil, two pencils, three pencils, total three pencil long space.
Children, do you think Pinky has properly measured her space? Yes, you thought right. Pinky has measured it correctly.
This means Chotu's space is more than Pinky's space. Come on, let me share your space equally.
Mother divided Chotu and Pinky's space equally between them. So children, did you see what mistake Chotu made? He left spaces between two pencils while taking measures with the pencil. That means Chotu did not measure the leftover space. So Chotu did not measure the entire length. We should measure without leaving any blank space while measuring. Today Chotu is measuring the length of the table at his home by his hand.
1, 2, 3, 4. Mummy, this table is 4 handspan long.
Chotu, my dear, this table is very long. How did you measure it? Can you measure it again and show?
Okay, Mummy. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is done, Mummy.
Hey, Chotu, don't leave any space while measuring. Look at me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Did you see, Chotu? This table is 8 handspan long while measuring with my hand. Now you two measure it.
Sure, Mummy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This table is 10 handspan long when I measured it.
Now you understood, Chotu. While measuring objects, we should not leave space between two hands. If we do not measure the entire length or miss any space in between, then the measurement will be wrong.
Okay, Mummy. This means that whenever a measurement is to be made, there should not be any space left between two measures.
You are absolutely right, Chotu.
So, children, did you see? You should not leave a space between two hand spans because that measurement might go wrong. So, children, that was all for today. In this video, we saw some common mistakes in measuring the length of the objects. In the next video, we will see some more mistakes in measuring the length of the objects that should be avoided. Till then, bye, children.